mine. Though your heart is aching, smile, even though it's breaking. When there are clouds in the sky, you'll get by. If you smile through your fear and sorrow, smile, there may be tomorrow. You'll see the sun come shining through. If you light up your face with gladness, hide every trace of sadness. Although a tear may be ever so near, that's the time you must keep on trying. Smile, what's the use of crying? You'll find that life is still worthwhile if you just smile.
Pissing no pants yet? Yeah. I got a feeling it's gonna be PP Pants City around soon. Which one of you pricks is a leader? You're Rick, right? I'm Negan. And I do not appreciate you killing my men. Also, when I sent my people to kill your people, killing my people, you killed more of my people. Not cool. Not cool at all. You have no idea how not cool that shit is. But I think you're gonna be up to speed here real soon. You are so gonna regret crossing me here in a few minutes. Shit, yeah, you are. You see, Rick, no matter where you go, what you do, you don't mess with the New World Order. And the New World Order is simply this. And it's really fucking simple. Even if you're stupid, which you very may well fucking be, you can understand. You ready? Pay attention, here it comes. Give me your shit, or I will kill you. Today's career day. We have invested a lot in you so that you would know who I am and what I can do. You work for me now. You have shit, you give it to me. That's your job. I know that that is a mighty, nasty pill to swallow. Swallow it? You most certainly fucking will. You rule the roost. You thought you were safe. You built something. Get it? But the word's out. You are not safe. Not even close. In fact, you are fucked. Even more fucked if you don't do what I want, and what I want is half your shit. Now, if that's too much for you, you can go ahead and find steel or make more, and it'll eventually even itself out. This is your way of life, Rick. The more you guys fight back, the harder this would be. So if somebody comes knocking at your door, you let us in. We own that door. You try to stop us, and we will knock that fucking door down. You understand? No answer. You don't think you were going to get through this without getting punished, did you? Let me make this clear real quick. I'm sorry. I don't want to kill you people. Okay? Get that out the way right off the top. I want you to work for me. You can't do that if you're dead. Now, can you? Am I going to garden? But you did kill my people. A whole damn lot of them. More than I'm comfortable dealing with, actually. For that, you gotta pay. So now, I'm gonna beat the holy hell out of one of you. All this, just to see which one of you pricks gets the honor. Sucks, don't it? That moment you realize you don't know shit. Everybody's at the table waiting for me to order it. I just can't choose which one. It's so damn hard. I got an idea. Any. Many. Miney. Mo. Catch a tiger by his toe. If he hollers, let him go. My mother told me to pick the very last one. And you are it. Anybody moves, anybody does anything, cut the boy's other eye out, feed it to his father, and then we'll start. You can breathe. You can blink. You can cry. Hell, you're all gonna be doing that here in a minute.
Lee, who killed that man?
Who the fuck do you think?
God, they're coming for us.
No, they're not coming.
What are you talking about? You're fucking killing people.
Lower your fucking voice, okay? You don't understand. They're not coming for us. You need to know that I know what I'm doing. And you've got to trust me, okay? Look. Look at this. They don't know anything. If they did, they'd be here already. I mean, it's already over, man. We're okay. Okay? I didn't mean to wreck the fucking car, okay? In public. But we did. And if they would have called the cops, they already would have.
How could you?
No, Sal. You knew.
No, Lee. I knew about one, Lee.
No,
one.
No, Sal. You knew. Look. It's gonna be all right. It's gonna be all right. Come on. Fuck it. You know what we're gonna do? We're gonna have drinks. And forget about all this shit. Okay? Here, come on. Come on. Cheers!
Lee, this isn't funny.
So, I know what I'm doing, and you don't, okay? You know, I know how people think out there. You know, you can keep your eyes shut to the whole fucking world if you want to, but you need to hear me out at least.
No, I don't want to hear this, Lee.
Yes, you need to.
We can be as different as we want to be, but you can't kill people.
Says fucking who? You know what? Me? I'm good with the Lord. I really am. He and I are okay. And, you know, they have to tell you all that bullshit, you know, thou shalt not kill and all that. But you know what? There's a lot of things that I can't do. But killing isn't one of them. And I am not going to let those motherfucking bastards rape anyone again either.
No, Lee, that was one man. They couldn't have all been bad.
Come on. Come on, you know me. Right? I wouldn't do it otherwise. Wouldn't. I mean, I'm not a bad person. Listen. I'm a really good person, right? You don't need to feel bad, Sal. It's just that, you know, people like us, they're always fucking putting us down. Not us, okay? Look. This is everything. Okay? Everything you ever wanted. Come on. Just one more time. In a car. Right? Then we have a shot at a real life, Sal. Not this. A real one.
Did I bother you? How serious I am. I'm gonna say this in English. As your leader, I encourage you from time to time, and always in a respectful manner, to question my logic. If you aren't convinced that a particular plan of action I have decided is the wisest, tell me so. But allow me to convince you. I promise you right here and now, no subject will ever be taboo. Except the subject which is under discussion. The price you pay for bringing up either my Chinese or my American heritage as a negative is. I'll collect your fucking head. Just like this fucker here. Now, if any of you son of a bitches got anything else to say, now you're fucking Tom! I didn't think so. Gentlemen, the meeting is adjourned.
I mean, don't get me wrong. I mean, this place isn't too bad. I mean, I've stayed in work.
Oh, yeah, you stayed in work?
Not much of a view, though.
Let's get this party started, Charlie.
I love mine.
Will you press a couple?
Sure.
I'm going to get some music. Oh, my God, this is going to be so much fun. I can't believe
sure
you came with me.
I can't believe you came with me.
Right. You got mine?
Yeah. And I got mine.
Charlie, I'm gonna slip into something more comfortable. Can you help me? It's just like a shoelace.
Oh,
thank you.
Mm.
Much better. Wow, you're so strong, Charlie.
I haven't seen anything yet.
Okay, huh? That's good. We'll be right back. And you better be on that bed with your dormies. You're so cute.
How are you?
Oh, another one. Let's see.
Well,
I got some party favors. Do you like to dance?
You do, obviously. Oh.
Some
room. Aha! New game. Yeah,
funny girl. Let's play, Charlie. Are you gonna leave your shirt on?
Oh, it's just that, well, you see, I've never really done anything like this before. I don't.
Don't worry, I have.
I wanna leave the shirt on because I just don't really feel comfortable right now.
You're not comfortable?
No,
Oh, poor Charlie.
Wait, where are you going? What are you? That's my card.
I know it is.
What are you?
Let's see. Oh, yeah, we're gonna have a lot more fun.
Oh, shit. What else you got in there? Can I help you? Got anything in there? I mean, if there's anything you need.
Let's get wild, Charlie. Ooh, here's my little friend.
Wait, whoa. Look, my money's in my pants, okay? Just please. What? No, don't. Please. What are you doing? No.
We're just gonna play, that's all.
That's my brand new t-shirt. Jesus. No, don't look. Please don't look. No.
Oh, you look good enough to eat.
Really? Thank you.
Let's get this thing off you.
Whoa, careful with that, please. Whoa. I would help, but
that's
a bit.
Much better.
You say so much.
Oh. Much better.
I'm ready now.
Now, are you ready?
Yeah, I've been ready. Whoa! Do that again.
Do it again.
Ow! Wow! Oh.
You need another drink?
Maybe a bit. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Okay. Party time's gonna take a break
for a second. Wait, what do you mean it's gonna take a break? Wait, you're making a phone call.
929.
Wait.
66.
No, please, 25. No! Don't call. I will pay you back!
Yes, this is Charlie Ludwig's office. Oh, he's not back from lunch yet. Well, it's 3:30. Where is he? No, this is an urgent matter. Yes, connect me to a supervisor immediately. Hi, Richard Dreyer? Yes, I have a message for you. I have Charlie on the line. There he is.
Hi, Charlie Drake's here. Yes. Well, I wanted to let you know that I'm not going to be able to make it back this afternoon. No, you see, I got caught up in meetings. I mean, you know how it is. I'm always trying to do work. Yeah, you know me. I'm an overachiever. I know. I'm sorry. I can't make it to the huddle. I was gonna throw that to Dillman anyway. It's good. I'm writing this down. I'll have those copies on your desk first thing Monday. Okay, yeah, I know. You have a good weekend too. Yes, I'll talk to you later. Thank you. Bye.
Wow, Charlie. for a really good while when you want to be.
Let's go. Keep going. Keep going. Please go. Yeah. That's bad. Oh, shit. Oh.
What is this? This is not sweet and low. This is equal. Blue packet. Sweet and low is pink. Sweet and low, pink, equal, blue. It's not the same thing, is it? What equal contains is not my concern here. I don't care if it has fucking fairy dust in it. What I am concerned with is detail. I ask you to get me a packet of sweet and low. That isn't what I wanted. That isn't what I needed. That isn't what I asked for. And that shit isn't gonna work around here. You thought? Do me a fucking favor. Shut up, listen, and learn! Look, I know it's your first day, and you don't really know how things work here, so I will tell you. You have no brain. No judgment calls are necessary. What you think means nothing. What you feel means nothing. You are here for me. You are here to serve my interest and to protect my needs. So while it may look like a little thing to you, when I ask for a packet of sweet and low, that's what I want. And it is your responsibility to see that I get what I want. Am I clear? You are nothing. If you were in my toilet bowl, I wouldn't bother flushing it. My bath mat means more to me than you.
Hi.
Come on in.
Thank you.
Hi. Wow, you look great.
No, you too. I'm a mess.
Not at all. Wow, and those are beautiful shoes.
Thank you for noticing.
Oh, are they Nine West?
No. Kenneth Cole.
Oh, you're kidding.
No.
Wow. They are very sexy, and they really suit you.
Can we cut to the chase for just a sec? Just get the hard topics out of the way?
Hey, come on in. Okay. Sure. What's on your mind?
Well, it's just that whenever I've thought about lesbianism in the past,
mm-hmm.
I've always thought just... you, you know,
mm-hmm.
you
mm-hmm.
can't go there, can't get excited. I mean, like, what would we do, you know?
Oh, right. I mean, that is your big issue.
Right. But had such a wonderful time with you the other night.
Me too.
I really did. And so I have been marinating over things, and I have taken the liberty of getting some informational materials on the topic.
Oh.
I was wondering, would you like
it? Of course.
Okay.
Of course.
Well, this, and, but that's for later. And I know I'm jumping the gun. We should not. I don't want to scare you away with the weddings.
No.
This one was really funny. Do you like horses?
And okay.
But there was one pamphlet that was particularly intriguing to me, and that is this one here. Lesbian sex, hot, safe, sane.
Oh.
Do you know it?
No, but I mean, it sounds great. I would love to see it.
Okay. Well, I was very surprised to learn that lesbians accessorize. I did not know that.
Oh.
So, for example, on page 11, I dog-eared it.
Okay.
It shows some of the higher tech forms of lesbian accoutrement.
Oh. Wow.
So.
Wow.
Gosh. How would this work?
Right. Okay. I think that I would just strap it on and then...
Oh, no. I mean, you and I, we would certainly trade and share the load in terms of giving and receiving.
Oh, yes, okay.
But it does not address the actual, like, gross out factor, if you will.
Oh.
No offense.
Oh.
I'm sorry. I did not mean it like that. It's just...
Oh, none taken.
Okay.
None taken.
Good, because, I mean, look at you. Who wouldn't want to have sex with you? I mean, do you? But,
look, Jess, I think we're putting the cart before the horse with all of this high-tech lesbian sex toy stuff. Okay? We don't need any of that anyway.
We don't?
Yeah, me too. No, I myself have always preferred the standard, organic, old-fashioned way.
Right, okay. Nice. So, you're saying?
Oh, it's a lot like having sex with a man. You know, just minus one small thing. And you know, it's all those other things that work for women anyway.
You know? Well, yeah, that is certainly true.
Yeah.
Cheers?
Cheers.
Okay.
Put some music.
Nice place.
Oh, thanks.
Is that Barry Manilow?
No.
Barry White?
No.
Oh.
Whatever you need, of course.
Thank you.
Okay. It's okay, Jess.
Okay, I'm sorry.
It's okay.
I am.
Are you okay?
I'm okay.
Be sure.
Mm-hmm.
Here you go.
Okay.
Okay. I'm okay.
Okay.
All right.
It's just me.
All right. Okay. Right. Yeah. Okay. All right. Is this for tongue?
Oh, I think we should just see what happens. Okay?
Okay.
Let's play it by ear.
Okay.
Okay, great.
All right.
Come in.
Hey, Bianca. How you doing? You getting any better? Got the best doctor in town working on you. I couldn't wait any longer. Is she gonna be all right?
After the treatments, she has to rest. She doesn't work without resting. Keep me company?
Sure. You know, Bianca doesn't deserve this. She's a good person. She's warm and caring and loving.
I can see that. She doesn't have any parents?
No, they died when she was just a baby.
Oh, that's not fair.
She's a positive person, though. She doesn't let it get her down. More than anything, she just wants to have a normal life.
I can see that. She's wonderful.
Gus and I, we're so darn lucky with women.
What?
Well, Karen has a problem.
Maybe you shouldn't tell me.
Is it just between us?
Sure.
I can't let her hug me. And it bothers her.
Makes her. How does it bother her?
Well, she gets real frustrated. She's a very affectionate person. She likes to give everybody hugs, but I can't let her do that.
Does it hurt?
Yeah. Kind of a burning feeling. You know when it's 15 below and you've been outside all day and your feet get really cold?
Mm.
And then when you come in the house and they start to warm up,
mm.
It's that kind of burning feeling.
Happens to everyone?
Well, not with Bianca. Not so much. Is this your husband?
Yes. He died.
Do you have any kids?
No, no children.
You must get real lonely.
Lars, sometimes I get so lonely, I forget what day of the week it is. And sometimes even how to spell my name.
Hmm.
How about you? Tell me about Karen. I don't know her very well.
Karen's wonderful. My brother and I, we're darn lucky with women. She's got that problem, me not letting her hug me.
So you don't let people touch you?
No.
Isn't that hard to get away with?
Well, not here. Well, you know, because of all the layers.
You're right. We can't change Karen, but there is a cure for the burning.
Really?
Hmm. Sure.
Will it hurt?
Especially at first.
Well, all right. For Karen's sake. Nothing.
Hurt?
Not too bad. Whoa.
Okay. It's a little too much.
Yeah.
All right. We'll try something else. Okay.
No, sigh. I can take care of you. Yes. No. I have the perfect girl. She shows up, she hits her mark. I'll even fly out to the coast too. I could use some sun. I definitely could use a break. No, Sai, it'll be perfect. I'm telling you. Sai, can you hold on? Yeah, there's a pest in the office. I gotta take care of it. Hold on. Just hold on for a second. Michelle, would you please wait outside? I'm talking to the coast.
This is the coast too, Georgia. New York is the coast too.
Sai, look what you made me do. Ryan, yeah, could you get Sai back? I hung up on myself. No, I'll take care of it. What do you want, Michelle?
Terry Bishop is doing the Rainmaker, right? Didn't you promise to send me up for that part? Are you not my agent, too?
Stuart Pressman wants a name for that role.
Oh, I see. So Terry Bishop is a name?
No. When you want to send a steak back, Michelle Dorsey is a name.
Oh! I see.
Wait. You do this to me every time. I still have things to say. Come back. Come on. Let me start over. Terry Bishop
is on a soap opera. Millions of people watch her every day. She's known.
And that just qualifies her to ruin the Rainmaker? I've already done that part in Minneapolis, okay? I can act circles around Terry Bishop.
If Stuart Pressman wants a name, that's his affair. I know that it really disgusts you, Michelle, but a lot of people are in this business to actually make money.
And I'm not. Georgia, do not try to make me seem like I'm some sort of flake, okay? I am in this to make money, too.
Oh, really?
Yes, really.
Really? Well, you know, maybe I'm mistaken. Let's take a look, okay? Ugh! I didn't see it. Modern theater for the blind. Oh! Strindberg in the park. Big hit with the squirrels. Oh, I'm so sorry. Here's the moneymaker. The People's Workshop in Syracuse.
Okay, hold on now. I did 9 plays in 8 months in Syracuse, okay? I got great reviews. The New York critics gave me great reviews. Not that that's why I did it, but I got great reviews.
Well, yes, because God forbid you lose your standing as a cult failure.
Failure? Is that what you think of me, George? I'm a failure?
I am not going to get sucked into this conversation again. I will not.
Okay, look. I sent you a play to read. My roommate wrote it. I had a great part in it. Did you read it?
Where the hell do you get off sending me your roommate's play for you to star in? I'm your goddamn agent, not your fucking mommy. It is not my job to find plays for you to star in. I field offers.
Field offers.
That's what I do. Field offers.
Field offers. Really? Who told you that? The agent fairy? That was a significant piece of work, okay? I would have been magnificent in that part.
No one's gonna do that play, Michelle.
Why not?
Because it's a downer. Nobody wants to go see a play about a couple that moves back to the Love Canal.
Why not? It's a true story.
Who gives a shit? No one is going to pay $20 to go watch people living next door to chemical waste. Hell, you can do that over in New Jersey for free.
Okay. Listen up. I'm going to raise the $8,000 and I'm going to do Jeff's play, okay? In the meantime, I want you to send me out for some things. I want you to send me out for some radio commercials, voiceover ads, anything really. Tampax commercials, it doesn't matter.
I can't send you out for anything, Michelle.
Why not?
Because no one will work with you, all right? You finally made me say it. No one will work with you.
That's not true. I bust my ass for a part, okay? And you know that.
Yeah, and I know that you bust everybody else's ass in the meantime. You think a guy's got 4 weeks to put up a play? He wants to spend all his time arguing with you whether or not Anna can walk while she's dying or talk while she's singing or dancing.
That was 2 years ago? Two? Okay, and that guy was a jerk. Everybody knows that guy was a jerk, so you could go ahead with that.
They can't all be jerks, Michelle. You argue with everybody. You've got one of the worst reputations in this town.
So you're saying nobody in New York will work with me?
Oh, no, no. That's far too limited for the great Michelle Dorsey. Nobody in New York will work with you. Nobody in Hollywood will touch you. No one in fucking Bollywood will hire you. I sent you for a commercial. You played a tomato for 30 seconds. They went over a day and a half because you wouldn't sit down.
How can I sit down? I was a tomato. It wasn't logical.
You were a tomato! Tomatoes have no logic. Tomatoes can't move. They can't argue.
Exactly! Exactly. That's exactly what I said. How can a tomato sit down if a tomato can't move, huh, Georgia? Huh? I was a stand-up tomato, okay? I was a sexy, juicy beef steak tomato, okay? Nobody did a vegetable like me. I did an enzyme salad off Broadway once and knocked the critics off their ass.
I am trying to stay calm here. And Michelle, you are a wonderful actress.
Thank you.
But you're too much trouble. Get some therapy. For God's sake, please, go get some therapy. Go. Just go.
Okay. Thank you. You know what? This is ridiculous. I am going to raise that $8,000 and I'm going to do just play.
Michelle, you're not going to raise 25 cents because no one will hire you.
Oh, yeah? Want to bet?
Hello, Mrs. Draper. My name is Aaron Levinsky. I'm an attorney sent by the court. Mr. Middleton doesn't represent you anymore. Would you like to discuss your case? Look, I don't know if you can follow any of this, but do you understand that I'm going to go to court on your behalf? Tonight, I gotta go home to Brooklyn on the subway. That scares the shit out of me. I'm real tired. It's been a long day.
You're breaking my heart.
Terrific. She can talk.
Yeah, I can talk. I can talk, I can dance, I can juggle, I can do card tricks. What kind of show do I have to put on for you?
Did I say something wrong?
I don't know, it just seems like I can't get a fair trial unless I put on a show for, who is it now? Aaron Levinsky. Legally.
No, it's not like that.
Oh, no? Well, then how do I get to stand trial?
Well, first, you know...
How do I get to stand trial? That's what I want to know!
That's okay. Close the door, please. I'm her attorney.
Says who?
Says the court.
I'll be out here if you need me.
You, think I'm gonna need him?
Haven't you heard? I tend to lash out and strike people at random.
Yeah, I know. I was there. I think you broke his nose.
Really? Well, then I guess the day's not a total loss.
All right. What we got here is a 7:30 process. Mm-hmm. Now, this is a process whereby the state is assuming that...
Are you married?
Pardon me?
You got a missus.
Uh-huh.
She give good head.
You want to talk about your situation here or what? You've been indicted for manslaughter.
I know all that. I want to know why you're here.
The truth?
No, Levinsky, the bullshit. I love listening to bullshit, especially when I'm fucking drowning in it. I know why you're here. I know exactly why you're here. You're here. You're here because you want to see how crazy I am, right?
Nope.
No, you want to know just how crazy I really am.
There are two psychiatrists who already say that you are incompetent.
Yeah, yeah, Arendez and Morrison, Brick and Bright. Okay, you know what? Arendez can barely speak English, and Morrison is a very, very weird guy. Do you know how flashed in when you look? What about you, Levinsky? Are you weird too?
I must be okay. I'm looking. Oh, your mother said to take...
My mother? My mother? Fuck my mother! Why didn't you tell me you were working with them in the first place? My fucking mother?
I'm not working for them. Just hold your horses.
Why didn't you tell me? Okay, why didn't you? God damn it, damn it, damn it, damn it, damn it, damn it.
Hold it. Listen, lady. I came here to do my job in good faith.
What did she say?
Will you listen to me?
What did she tell you?
You know, you got a choice. You can either cooperate with me, and maybe it goes your way, or you can yell at me, and I will sign this motion to commit, and that'll be that.
No, you creeplers are all the same. All you want is your fee, and you don't give a shit about who goes where or for how long.
Hey, lady.
This guy.
I'm not taking any money from you.
This guy here is like, oh, well, you know what? If you don't kiss ass, I'm gonna walk. Well, you know what? Walk.
Oh, and be held in contempt of court? No, thank you. It doesn't work that way. I am stuck with you. Oh, my. First thing we gotta get is a shrink in here. Take a look at you.
No, wrong. No more shrinks, okay?
I am giving you some very good legal advice here.
Well, I appreciate that. I really, really do. But you know what I said about lawyers? Well, it goes double for shrinks, okay?
Mrs. Draper, two psychiatrists already say that you are crazy. You have got to have at least one psychiatrist who says you are not crazy or you don't have a case.
Yes, I do. Sure, I do. Okay, I am my case, okay? I just get up there, I say my piece, I prove that I'm competent, okay? I don't know if you believe this or not, but I am a perfectly sane woman, okay? I mean, I don't bother anyone that doesn't bother me first, and I don't need any more quacks running around in my head talking to me about my freaking toilet training, okay?
There's one thing that scares me. A stupid client. You terrify me. You ever testify in court?
No.
So you've never been cross-examined, you have no idea what it's like?
Nope.
How long have you been hooking?
3 years.
3 years, you've never been busted?
Never. Now tell me I'm incompetent.
Well, look, Mrs. Draper, it just doesn't look good for you to beat the shit out of one of the top attorneys in the city.
Yeah, well, it didn't look good, but sure. Sure as hell felt good. I mean, what was I supposed to do? Just sit up there while my own attorney told me I was too incompetent to stand trial?
Are you?
How competent do you have to be, for Christ's sake?
Good point. Let's just say, for the moment, that you're not entirely incompetent.
Yeah, let's say that.
Let's say, for the moment, that the doctors here, they're all wrong.
Let's say that too.
Then why is all of this happening to you? Mrs. Draper, do you want me to represent you in this competency hearing?
I don't know. Are you any good?
You had good. Now you got me.
I guess I could do worse, huh?
Yeah, don't be so sure. You know, we win at the hearing, you get a trial. You lose at the trial, you could go to jail for 25 years.
I mean, I guess I'll take the chance, right? Not I could be stuck wearing this robe until I collect Social Security.
Oh, McMillan is gonna eat me alive. All right. Let's start at the beginning.
Fine.
Give me some background details.
Look, before we do this, you're gonna sit here and you're gonna talk to me like I am a perfectly sane human, okay?
Okay,
and I'll do the same for you.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Cheers.
Great work, guys.
You super late for the business meeting, and by the way, our boss was not happy about it.
Where are we going?
Up. How far up? Like 26 stories up.
Inez, I'm scared of heights.
It'll be okay.
So
yeah. Well, you're not leaving out of the elevator. Well, it's gonna have to because the elevator door's shut.
Oh my god.
So.
Oh my god. Oh.
So glass. It's okay.
It's not okay.
Taking the smell of Dolce and Gabbana.
Well, it's nice, but we're still, oh god, oh, it's moving, it's moving.
It's okay.
I can't look, Ines.
Just look down there.
I can't look down there. It's, oh, it's so far down.
Of course it is. Look down. You see all the little insect people down there?
I see them. I see them.
There are hundreds of men. Men of all faces and men of all races. Hundreds of them.
Well, there's women, too.
We're not worried about the women. Oh. Just keep looking at them. I'm going to lock this door so you don't go anywhere.
Oh,
I don't trust
God.
You. We don't care about the men. Or the women. Just the men.
Just the men. Oh, okay. Men.
Yeah. Take a look at all of them. Pay kind of attention. And believe me, some of them will want you.
I don't think any of them want me.
Wrong. Look down there and tell me what they're doing.
Well, they're going to work, going shopping, just walking around, living their lives. I don't know.
No. They're slowing down.
Okay.
And do you know, stand a little closer, and do you know why they're slowing down?
Yeah, there's a stoplight right there.
Again, no. They're looking up our dresses.
What?
Yeah,
what?
That's why we didn't have any underwear on. I told you not to wear any. Are you doing what I asked you to do?
Yes, I am. And you know what? It's the scariest thing I've ever done in my life.
Why?
I didn't sit on the subway. What are you doing? Are you trying to put me on one of these
websites?
I
don't have any on either. So, I mean.
How do I know that?
I mean, I'll show you. Like,
no,
you,
that's okay. That's okay. That's okay, Inez.
You're a loss. They're looking up our dresses.
They can't see
this
high up.
Yes, they can. You're wrong again. Because when guys want to look up a girl's dress, they have the eyes of an eagle.
Oh, my goodness.
Now, stand a little closer. Set that down because that's in my way. You're going to spread your legs.
I most certainly will not.
And
who knows what kind of perverts are down there?
Let them see what they got under your skirt. There's all kinds of men from all over the world. You have religious men. You have rich men, poor men, lovers, haters, scandalous people. And now they're all looking up my dress.
You're going to get us arrested.
By who? The cops? Fuck, they're looking too. I mean, take a look at it. Like, come on. It's our power, and they're going to observe it. What do you think they're going to do? It's not like we can get in trouble.
I'm pretty sure this is illegal. Yeah, actually.
No, it's not, because we're wearing dresses, duh. It's not our fault if they want to look. Like, just spread your legs.
Oh, my gosh.
Your power. Come on.
I feel like an idiot.
Well, you shouldn't, and that's why you're wrong. Because, okay, yeah. Because your hoo-ha has ran the entire world. From the test of time. Do you not want to feel important? Do you not want to feel like a valued individual? Do you not want them to see your power?
I don't think of my hoo-ha as power.
Well, that's where you're wrong. Because it's ran the world from the test of time. Again. Now, stand closer, lift your skirt, and let them see your power.
Okay. I'm doing it.
Okay. Now.
So weird.
No, it's not. Shut up. Take your head back and close your eyes. Feel them stare at you. They're looking at you, all those men on the street. There's men from all over America. There's Englishmen, there's Irishmen, there's Chinese men, there's Japanese men. There's Mongolian men, but you're not really worried about them because they're really depressing in bed, so they're the last ones. You can go ahead and mark them off. But feel them adore you. You have power as a woman. They see where they started, and they long to return from which once they were created. Feel their desire, Wanda.
I feel it, and I don't think I like it.
They're adoring us, Wanda. They see the start from once they came. We are the cauldron, Wanda. We are where humankind was created. We are the survival of all humankind. We are the temple of God. We are the instrument of the goddess.
It's getting warm in here, Ines.
Yeah, it is. Feel their warmth on your stare. Feel their passion stare you. Feel their desire. Fuck. Feel them crave you. It's the power. You feel it?
I
feel it.
Yeah, you do. Feel the power and let it surge through you. Wars have been fought over your... Nana. Feel the power surge through you and feel the energy. I want you to repeat after me. Say it. I am the power. Say it. I am the power.
I am the power.
Creation happens inside me.
Creation happens inside me.
All humankind springs from me.
All humankind springs from me.
I am woman. All powerful.
You're right, Inez. Mm-hmm. I am woman. All powerful.
Yeah, you are.
I am Wanda the Wonderful.
Fuck yeah, you are.
Oh, I feel their gaze. I feel their desire.
Yeah, you do.
I feel it rising up.
Lift your skirt higher. Squat lower.
I feel them looking.
Right.
Oh, I feel it. I feel it rising up. Ooh. Look at me, all you pathetic little men. Look. Look. See my flower. See my sacred jewel and shake with desire.
All right.
Oh, there's so many of them.
Just chill out.
Yes, yes, yes.
Okay. You feeling yourself?
They're looking. They're looking, and I love it. Oh, they want me bad, Inez.
You gotta calm down just a little bit.
Oh, they want me.
Just a hair.
They want me.
Did you at least shave?
Oh, yes, yes, yes.
Yes, all right, cool. You're shaking your head. Feel
yourself. That's good. Yes, yes. See me. See my power. See my glory.
Yep.
Oh, yes, yes, yes. Ah, the whole city.
You're shaking. Wanda. Get a hold of yourself.
Calm down. I'm sorry.
Center your chakra.
I was so depressed. That was...
I know. Calm down. You gotta relax, though. I'm like, I know you're feeling yourself, honey, but you caused 1, 2, 3 bike wrecks, and I'm pretty sure someone ran a red light.
Oh, wow. Inez, that was better than any drink, better than any yoga session.
I mean, tell me about it. I had something for you in here, but I think I left it at home. It seemed like you were doing well on your own. But I'm telling you, you're gonna be feeling that for a while.
I did something.
About like a week from now. Every time I come up here to recharge, and I walk through the office. God, the boys don't leave me alone for days. You have no idea how hard of a life that is to live. Yes.
I'm ready.
I know you are. But I think it's time for us to get back, because the last thing I want to do is explain to HR why the guy on the bike backed into his car.
Wait, can we do another charge up on the way down?
Fine. Yes. But you have to promise me you're not going to overdo yourself, because... maintenance isn't going to have fun cleaning that up.
I promise I won't get carried away.
Okay. You're good, then. Don't mention this to anybody.
Thank you, Inez.
You're welcome.
Great, girls. Great.
Special agent. Damn good one, too. But it wasn't always that way. Many years ago, back in 2016, my partner and I, we were chasing a kung fu assassin through the streets of Detroit. Cornered him in a back alley. And I was gonna let this punk know that his time was up. So I yelled out, "Your time's up, punk." My partner went to put the cuffs on him.
Hey,
look,
that is
Aaron.
I'll take it.
Yeah.
And
why?
We're gonna scare him out of here.
Bro, please. Say, bro, whenever this stupid ass substitute teacher comes in, let's throw these paper airplanes at his dumb ass.
You know what? I have on some account.
Here we go.
1, 2, 3.
Oh,
shit!
Bitch, you're dead, bitch.
Look at this goofy.
fucking briefcase.
Why
are
you not laughing?
This shit is funny.
It's funny, dude. Come on,
man. What are we even doing here?
I'm
gonna say this one more time. All right, everybody. All right, everybody. Are we here? All right. Now that I got y'all attention, okay. I'm your substitute teacher for the day. Uh-huh. My name is Mr. Garvin. I've been working in the inner city for 24 years.
Ooh.
24 years.
24.
So don't none of y'all think about messing with me.
He didn't pluralize years.
Let's take Rose.
Teacher, homie. That's what I
want.
Who wrote this shit?
Was that you?
Wait, that was you?
Get it.
That's good.
You think you're gonna make
5 minutes? Let's take roll, everybody.
Let's get this over with.
I know, right?
Jay Quellen.
What?
Is that Jay Quellen?
That's not Jay.
Jay Quellen.
No, Jay Quellen.
My name don't start with a J.
Jay Quellen.
I'm Blake.
Yes, ma'am.
Jacqueline.
Oh, he's starting off on a bad foot, bro.
Jacqueline.
Okay. So that's how it's going to be.
Goddamn Jacqueline. Right.
That's my nephew from across the track.
All right, Jacqueline. All right.
Get my shit right. I'm talking about some damn J.K. Right.
Blockhead.
Blockhead.
Is there a blockhead?
That was second grade. I was called blockhead.
No blockhead here today.
Oh, you're still a blockhead.
You're still a blockhead.
Yes, Blake, varsity football player. Get it right.
What? He threw his Letterman jacket at you.
Are you out of your goddamn mind? Blake? What? Do you want to go to war, Balaki?
Oh. Because
we could go to war.
Oh.
I'm for real.
Is he serious,
man? I'm going to record it.
I'm for real.
Oh, hell no.
So you better check yourself.
No, I need to go to the gym and pump some iron right now if he just touched me like that.
I'm pretty sure that's a
loss.
Better watch out.
I got
it on camera, dude.
That's some bullshit.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, good. So you were recording
that?
Yeah.
That's
no, illegal.
I forgot, my bad.
What are you doing?
You had that chip on the phone.
Dude, did you respond to that? I ain't drinking whiskey.
I'm gonna fuck they find this clown.
D-Nice. Zara D-Nice.
Denise.
If one of y'all says some silly ass name,
I'm gonna rap him.
This whole classroom is gonna feel my rap. Not D-Nice.
Nice.
Say it again.
Denise. I know what he means, but I think he wants me to say.
Say your name right. Right now.
Man, I'm saying what you.
Say your name right. Right now. Correctly. Right.
Denise.
That's better. Thank you. Now.
Okay.
Okay. Aaron.
Make up names for
everybody. Is there an Aaron?
This is the craziest substitute teacher I've ever seen.
You better be sick, dead, or mute, Aaron.
Who the hell is
Aaron?
He's a fucking
oh.
No, Aaron.
Oh. It's Aaron.
I told you. I told you.
Bitch.
I told you.
The nerd.
Why don't you say your name the first time I said it?
I did. I said it right. Oh,
I said, why didn't you say your name the first time I said Aaron.
That's Aaron. Oh, man. He's really
you done messed up, Aaron. Now take your ass on down to old Shaq Hennessy's office and tell him exactly what you did.
Old Shaq
Hennessy.
Old Shaq
Hennessy.
Get out of my goddamn classroom before I break my foot off in your ass. Insubordinate and churlish.
Okay.
Timothy.
What was that word?
Churlish.
Churlish.
Timothy.
You present.
Thank you.
Bro.
You fucking sold out.
Like, for real. Big ass sell out.
Are you for real right now?
Thank you.
Timothy, bro.
That's Timothy now.
Oh, that's that step up from the regular Henderson. Oh, yeah, I got to try some day. Might be in that wicked ass bag he got back there. All right, can we go? I mean, I'm real much, bro. You know what? Let's ditch. Clown ass. So we ain't taking class today. Nope.
Please, you take your ass to all Shaq
Henderson. Shaq!
Mr. Chairman, can I please say something before we adjourn tonight? Please?
Not yet, honey. Can please, you move the
right
micro-
now.
Can
no,
you move the microphone?
Right now. Right now. Now, I really have to do this. And don't tell me no, because I know where you live. Just tell me.
Okay.
Can I please?
Yes, yes,
thank
you.
Thank you.
Yes,
oh, my gosh. Better count the votes next time he is elected. Okay, I just want to say I love this microphone. Okay, can you hear me? This is such a great addition to our town hall. I know it's very small, but I really like it. It makes me want to push my own personal political agenda upon you, but I know the chairman will throw something at me or yell, so I won't. But I do have some very important announcements tonight to make to you. One of them is, Ms. Wilkerson, can you hear me? Can you please turn your hearing aid? Turn it up. Turn it on. Turn it. Can you hear me? Okay. I'm sorry to tell you, your cat is dead. I'm sorry. Your neighbor paid me to tell you that because he didn't want to see you cry. He ran over it this morning. So I've been thinking about this all day long. Please don't cry. Oh, my gosh. If you will not cry, I'll tell you what. I have a solution. We will round up all the cats in town, the 30, 40 cats, you know, not the ones in the woods because they'll scratch your eyes out, but the ones in town, they're wonderful. And we'll get somebody to round those things up, bring them to your house. It won't be me because I hate cats, but somebody will. And we'll bring them to your house. We'll cram all those cats in your house. You can lock the door. You can go through those cats, pick out which ones you want, which ones you don't. You have the option. You can keep all 30 or 40 of them. Our gift to you. That would be great. Are you happy now? I see you smiling. Are you happy? Good. Okay. Cat problem solved. Okay. One other thing I really have to say before we adjourn for tonight is, my name is Joan Harbor. I've already told you that. I work for the town paper. So my editor told me that in order to keep my job, I have to apologize to Earl. Earl, I wrote some things last week, and I really didn't think he was going to print them, but he did. So he said in order to keep my job, I have to publicly apologize. So, Earl, I am very sorry that I said that your literacy was driving me so crazy that I wanted to light you on fire and run over you with my car. So I'm sorry. I'm very sorry. So, anyway, okay, cat problem solved. I've apologized to Earl. So I'm going to go home and have several adult beverages right now because this town just drives me crazy. Anyway, y'all have a very safe evening. We'll see you in 2 weeks, and thank you very much.
Catherine Murphy.
Why did you let them out on bail?
I didn't. It was standard procedure. Until a jury finds them guilty, they can post bail.
That guy on TV, he made it seem like I did a live sex show or something.
Well, that's not the last time that's going to happen. May I come in?
Come on.
The bartender at the dugout said you were sick.
You ain't looking for me? I had to go to the doctor's. Nobody at my job knows. You want a seat or a drink?
Thank you. No.
It's just to smooth out the edges a little. Listen. What time were you born?
I already told you, I don't believe in that astrology.
I do. What time?
Midnight, August 9th.
Where?
Portland. Do you always drink to smooth out the edges?
No. Sometimes I have hit a pot. Why? You want some?
Did you have anything to drink before you went to the mill? Or smoke anything?
I had half a joint, a couple of beers, and didn't have you anything.
And while you were there?
I don't know. I wasn't falling down drunk, if that's what you're trying to say.
How were you dressed?
What is that supposed to mean?
It means, were you dressed provocatively? Showing a lot of cleavage, see-through blouse.
What the fuck does it matter how I was dressed? They tore it off of me anyways.
But did how you dress make those guys think they could have sex with you? Did you put on a show?
What the hell are you talking about? You saw me at the hospital. You think I wanted this? Is that what you think? If that's what you think, you can get the fuck out of my house.
Why didn't you tell me you had a record?
Fuck you. I ain't got no record.
You want to tell me about it?
All right. I was helping my girlfriend move. You know, she was gone to Jersey. And we got stopped by this cop because we had a busted taillight. And she had all this stuff on her desk. And he started going through it, and he found a half gram of coke. I mean, it wasn't big or anything, but it was her desk, not mine. It was her stuff.
Why is it on the books?
I don't know. You tell me. I mean, my record, it was definitely...
Expunged?
Yeah. Expunged.
Have you ever made love to more than one man at a time?
What the fuck kind of question is that?
It's the kind of question you're going to be asked on the stand. And you're going to be asked if Larry or any other man hit you and if you liked it. You're going to be asked about your drug busts and how many drinks a day you have to smooth out the edges and how many joints and how often you go to bars alone and whether or not you wear underwear when you go to them and which diseases you've caught and how many abortions you've had. And I'm going to object to all those questions. And sometimes a judge will sustain me and sometimes not.
Ain't fair.
Sarah, you're a witness. And it's the defense attorney's job to show that you're a rotten witness because you got a rotten character.
I've got a rotten character? So you're not going to defend me because I'm just this low-class bimbo, right?
I didn't say that.
Will those bastards get put in jail?
Is that what you want?
I want the motherfuckers put away. Forever.
get a divorce. You just got married.
Oh, really? He wants me to do things.
Sexual things? Dirty things?
Not sex, like actually do things, like cook dinner and all that crap. I need a nap.
I think you're making a big woo-hoo over nothing. Now don't be stupid.
Is Britney Spears stupid? Is Melanie Griffinith stupid? Because they both left bad marriages. Get my bags.
I am not carrying your bags, young lady.
Well, I'm moving back in.
You can't just move back in.
What the hell did you do to my room? You turned into a freaking cards! Oh, the rug is so nice.
I know. And we're having a half off sale at the Z Gallery. It's different, isn't it?
It's so cute. Where are all my Care Bears? If you gave Teddy Vedder to Salvation Army, I'm gonna freak out!
You never give anything a chance. You did the same thing with high school. And that job at the car wash.
Would you forget about that job? My life is crap. I need cookies.
I know you're upset, but we need to keep a level head about this. The chocolate donuts are for company. Kim, look at me. Look at me. That's one. That's two. Two and a half. What did you think marriage was going to be like? Flying off on your private jet? To have cocktails with the Prince of Delmonico?
Sign up to cook dinner, or, like, be interested in how somebody's day was. I'm a trophy wife. You know, like Melania Trump? Or like Mrs. Larry King Live?
I heard that Larry and Shawn are having big problems.
That's so terrible.
So sad. These Hollywood marriages, I tell you.
What do you do for him?
Who, Frank?
Yeah, Frank.
I tin bar.
Tin bar and what else?
I deliver things.
What kind of things?
Well, some pretty weird shit.
Like what?
Well, once I took this box up to a guy in Detroit, I took the Greyhound. So I'm sitting on the bus, 6 hours, wandering. I go into the bathroom in the back of the bus, open the box, look inside, and there's a human hand in there with the manicured nails and a wedding band. I almost died. So I get up to Detroit. I deliver it to some guy behind a counter in a bowling alley. This guy, he opens the box, looks inside, and he gives me a tip, like I was delivering takeout.
Do you sleep with him?
Who, Frank? I don't think he has sex.
Does he make you sleep with anyone else?
No.
So then you never had to sleep with anyone else then, huh?
Why is it that the worst thing that a guy can imagine is that she fucks some other guy?
That's not what I'm driving at, okay? And I never said anything like that.
Okay, well, what are you driving at?
I don't know. Okay? So there, I don't know. I go out there, I do my job, and I help people. But I'm not a warrior, and I sure as hell ain't some hero. Sorry.
I'm not asking you to save me, Wade.
So is that what this is all about? Is that you need to be saved? So just tell me then. I need to be saved.
Look, for the next 4 days, let's just pretend that we're your basic normal couple, okay? Watch TV, all right? Hey, Wade. Mm-hmm. Could you put your arm around me?
Okay. Good. Okay, good. We don't have to do anything if you don't want to. Okay, good. Because I can go for that.
Okay. I don't want to do anything.
Okay, good. Well, we don't have to then.
Okay.
Okay.
You're a good man, you know that.
Yeah. You don't say. Yeah, thank you. Whoa, we don't have to do anything if you don't want to. Okay.
Open your lips.
I know how to kiss, okay? Whoa, whoa, whoa. Whoa, I need it. I need to go do some sit-ups.
Right now?
No. I don't mean like right. I don't mean like right now. In 2 years like that.
Made love? I like that saying.
And watch out for next time, too.
Oh, there'll be a next time.
Yeah.
Yeah?
I hope so. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, that's gonna be nice.
It's like we're coming out of the round table days, Sir Lancelot.
Oh, okay.
Your file says you've served 40 years of a life sentence. You feel you've been rehabilitated?
Rehabilitated? Let's see. Come to think of it, I have no idea what that means.
It means you're ready to rejoin society.
I know
as
what
a...
you think it means. I think it's a made-up word, a word... political word, politician's word, so people like, young folks like you could wear a suit, tie, have a job. Why don't you ask me what you really want to know? Am I sorry for what I did?
Well, are you?
Not a day goes by I don't feel regret, and it's not because I'm in here. It's not because you think I should. I look at what I used to be. Stupid kid who did that terrible crime. Wish I could talk some sense into him. But tell him how things really are. But he's too late. Kid's long gone. All that's left is this old man, and I'll just have to live with it. Rehabilitated? That's a bullshit word. So you just go ahead and stamp that form there, Sonny, and quit wasting my damn time. Truth is, I really don't give a shit.
Harry Lieberman.
So, I'm to speak with you about my work with the adoption agency.
That is correct.
I don't mind. What I did may have been slightly illegal, but I did bring happiness to so many people, and that's what's important, huh?
Now, tell me how you came to work for this agency.
In the spring of 1963, I was contacted by someone I knew in Comrades organization.
Who?
Frau Maloney will not answer that.
They had helped me after the war. They wanted me to return the favor by getting a job at an adoption agency.
Did they say why?
If you let me finish, you'll find out. The Rusk Gaddis Agency hired me. The Comrades organization was interested in rejects, couples who had been denied children because the husband was too old. I had to go through files of applications. Specifically, families with Nordic Christian backgrounds. The husband had to be born between 1910 and 1914, and the wife between 1933 and 1937. The husband had to have had a job in civil service. They both had to be in perfect physical health.
Now, did they tell you why they wanted you to do all of this?
That information is not relevant.
I was expected to obey orders, not question them. This I did, as I always had. A few years later, I was ordered to contact several of the applicants and offer them a little white baby boy, complete with New York State adoption papers. They were to pay me $500 when they received the babies, after the certificates cleared. We would meet at a motel near Kennedy Airport that used to be Idlewild. The babies were delivered to me by stewardesses who usually worked with Varick Airlines.
Varick? The babies come from Brazil.
Is that important to you?
Now, what did these babies look like?
They were beautiful baby boys with black hair and piercing blue eyes. And if you're looking for a long-lost Jewish grandson, he was not among them.
Now, how many couples did you give these babies to?
About 20.
Only American?
Some Canadian.
No European?
No.
Do you remember a Curry family?
The Curry. Yes.
Anyone else?
Wheelock. Henry Wheelock. They gave me my dog Shotzi. Beautiful Doberman. I got him when he was only 10 weeks old.
And where is this Wheelock from?
New Providence, Pennsylvania.
How long was it from the time you got the baby to the Currys till the time you gave the baby to the Wheelocks?
That was 14 years ago. I don't remember.
Now, what has Joseph Mengele to do with all of this?
We won't answer that. It's all a trick, wasn't it? I know nothing of Mengele. But you'll link me with him, won't you? You want your pound of flesh, and you don't care how you get it. 30 years! The world has forgotten! Nobody cares. You persist and persist! Why don't you get off my back?
One more brief question.
I'll say nothing to you.
As you will. This interview has not gone to any extent to my agreement I had with you. I will therefore withhold the two depositions we talked about.
You lying Jewish schmuck!
You're not a guard anymore, madam! You're a prisoner. I may be leaving here empty-handed, but you are not going anywhere.
I think Frau Maloney can answer one more question.
What is the dog's birthday?
You are an insane old man, aren't you? Shotzi's birthday? It was December 11th.
Yep.
Ms. Holloway, please step into my office immediately.
Yes, Mr. Gray.
All right. The phone's ringing. Bring! Bring!
Okay. Thank you for calling the office of Mr. Gray.
Ms. Holloway, when I hired you, you told me you were good at answering the phones.
I am.
Did you get enough sleep last night?
Yeah.
And the phone's ringing!
Thank you for calling the office of Mr. Edwards.
No, 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 no! Put it down! Louder. You can get a much bigger voice out of that tiny throat. Bring!
Thank you for calling the office of Mr. Edward Gray. How may I help you?
You see? You see? After all, we're not running a mortuary.
No.
Lee.
Mr. Gray.
Come here. Sit. Did you have a date last night?
Yes.
And with whom did you have a date?
Peter.
Peter. Did you have sex?
Oh my God.
No?
I don't know.
Miss Holloway, are you shy? Because I'm shy.
You're not shy, you're a lawyer.
I am shy. I just overcome my shyness in order to get things done.
I don't think you're shy.
Ms. Holloway, I'm going to be very frank with you now. Now I understand that I am your employer, and we have a prescribed relationship,
But I want you to feel free to come to me with anything, any kind of problems. Feel free to tell me about them.
Okay.
What's going on with the Band-Aids and the sewing kit?
I feel shy.
Would you like some hot chocolate?
Okay.
Lee, why do you cut yourself?
I don't know.
Is it because sometimes the pain inside has to come to the surface? And when you use the evidence of that pain inside, you finally realize that you're really here. And when you watch that wound heal, it's comforting.
I guess you can say that.
Now, I want you to listen to me. Are you listening?
Yes, sir.
You are never, ever going to cut yourself again. Do you understand me?
Yes, sir.
Do I make myself perfectly clear?
Yes, sir.
Now, I want you to take off early today. You're a big girl. A grown woman. Your mother does not need to be picking you up from work today.
No, sir.
I want you to take a long walk through the park because you need some fresh air. Because you really need some relief. Because you are never, ever going to cut yourself again. Will you?
No.
Good.
Yeah, good boy. That was great.
Everything. But
How you doing, Miss Jackie?
I was expecting you. Come in.
You got some booze?
I got some vodka.
You got some OJ?
Yeah.
Should be a good hostess to make me a screwdriver.
Sure.
So you gonna thank me?
For what?
You think I got that fine ass out of jail?
The same guy who put me in. Thanks a lot.
Now you the one that got busted. But that's all our business.
It wasn't mine.
That's right. Must have been Mr. Walker slipped it in there for Melanie, huh? Shit, he must have done it. You didn't even know about it. Baby, I apologize for that. That shit's uncalled for. I imagine they asked you a whole lot of questions. All that money. Imagine they asked you who it was going to, too, huh?
Yes.
And what was your answer?
I told him I wanted to talk to a lawyer.
You sure about that? I mean, you ain't letting something slip by mistake? Maybe he was a little nervous. Maybe if he did, I ain't mad at you. I just gotta know.
You're not asking the right questions. Beaumont Livingston.
I knew it.
And they asked if I knew Mr. Walker.
Yeah?
I didn't tell him anything.
My name come up? Sure you ain't saying nothing about me? Oh, baby, that's mighty honorable of you. Now, they say what happened to old boy?
They told me.
They must have been real scared of what he might say to keep from doing some time. You scared of me?
Nope.
Is that what I think it is?
What do you think it is?
I think it's a gun pressing against my dick.
Well, you thought right. Now get your hands from around my throat, nigga.
What the hell are you doing, girl?
Shut your ass up and grab the wall.
Man. Girl, that ain't got nothing to do with you. I just carry that, all right? Them cops been messing with your head.
Yeah? The cops ain't trying to strangle my ass.
Girl, I was just playing with
you. Well, I'm not playing with you. Now, I'm gonna unload both these motherfuckers. You don't do what I tell you. You understand what I'm saying?
Girl, I just came
here. I said, do you understand what I'm saying?
I understand, woman. Damn.
Go sit your ass on that sofa.
You know, that's how the cop do, huh? Get black against black.
Shut your raggedy ass up and just sit down. Mm-mm. Put both hands behind your head.
She's getting silly now.
If I gotta tell you shut up one more time, I'm gonna shut you up.
Baby, I just came here to talk.
Way I see it, me and you only got one thing to talk about. What you willing to do for me?
I'll get you a good lawyer.
Let's get realistic, baby. You see, sooner or later, they're gonna get around to offering me a plea deal. And you know that. And that's why you came here to kill me.
Baby, I ain't coming here to kill
you. No. It's okay. I forgive you. Now, let's say if I tell on you, I walk. But if I don't, I go to jail.
Yeah?
I want $100,000 put in an escrow account in my name. If I'm convicted, up to a year or put on probation. But if I get more than a year, you add another $100,000.
I got a problem.
All your money's in Mexico.
Yeah.
You see, I've been thinking about that too. And I got me an idea. I'll talk to the cops tomorrow, and I'll let you know if it's on.
I'll talk with you tomorrow.
Yeah, girl. Yeah. Great work, Nick.
I'm really sorry that it took me so long to tell you about this, but today's the anniversary. It happened October 14th of 2009. I was still a college undergrad. And at that time, you just think you're absolutely indestructible. Nothing's gonna hurt you. Well, I was in one of my classes and just got a bout of fucking excruciating pain. Just, mind you, as a female, never really got period cramps much. Never had that problem. Never felt that before. So obviously, being a girl, freaking out, went to the student health center. And just pain after pain, just cramping and bleeding, just profusely. I was very afraid, very scared. Something I've never experienced before. And I get to the waiting room, and the nurse calls me in to take my vitals to run some blood, and she sat me back up, and she said, I'll come get you as soon as we know something. So I sit back out in the waiting room, and then I hear a pitter-patter, a very familiar pitter-patter. She's running down the hallway. And she's yelling for me. She's like, Miss Parker, we need you in the room. We need you back in the room. We need you in there now. Like, we've gotta run these tests on you. We've gotta check you out. We gotta get you taken care of. And no one is answering my questions. What is wrong with me? What is going on? She leads me to a room in the back, and the first thing I lay eyes on is a crash cart. And it's never a good sight to see, especially as someone who studies medicine in college. Obviously, there's something really wrong going on here. And, she lays me down on the table and pulls my shirt up and puts that really cold shit that you do an ultrasound with. It was gooey. And, everything went quiet. Because all I heard was thump, 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 really slow, like. She ran out the room and she was screaming, we gotta grab the doctor, we'll save it, it's okay, we'll save it. And I'm like, save what? And she left me alone in that room. And it slowed down. Just thump, thump, thump. And it stopped. And she ran back in. She heard me screaming. And I'm like, it's dead. What do I do? What do I do? And she said, there's nothing we can do. She said, you have to pass it. So after 2 hours of excruciating pain, she asked me, do you want to hold him? Do you want to hold him? Not it. It was a boy. And she put it in my hand, and it was small, and it was pink, and it was still warm. Do you know what it's like to be on this earth, to be made, to create life, to let it thrive, and you're the one thing that killed it? I'm never gonna hear that child cry. I'm never gonna hear it laugh. I'm never gonna watch it run. And I'm never gonna see it smile. All because of me. So ask me again why I don't like going to the park. Ask me again why I don't like being around children. Because I'm a monster. Because I'll never get to know mine.
Chairs. Where's my baby? My babies. Wake up.
Such a good boy. Oh no, she's fussy.
It's a good boy. It's a good boy. I'm sorry. Just.
Always during interviews.
So, I have been a hairdresser now for 14 years, and I went to this show, and I saw this guy showing off his dog, and I was like, that's my ex-wife. Who's that? She was like, well, this is Scott. He shows a good dog, and I've just never saw anybody
as light as on his feet as Sky.
Light in the loafers. I only wear Jimmy Choo. And you know
my
that.
God. Say yes. It. Yes. Say yes. It. Jimmy Choo. Jimmy Choo.
Wait
more Jimmy
I tell
Choo.
Your mother.
Stop it. Anyway. You got it?
Yeah.
Okay. So anyway. So I asked Deb. I said, who's this guy? She said it was Scott. And he cuts hair and he shows dogs and he is a genius. Absolute genius.
Can you tell about how when I would walk the boards away, you describe me. You describe me as being someone who had two members. Those are your words, not mine.
I didn't know we were gonna bring that up, but okay. So it's just him, Scott and his bourgeois just had like the same prance. It's like they were two members on the same body. It was a wonderful sight to see. Absolutely wonderful.
I once knew a man who had two members on the same body.
Stop Bitch. It!
Oh, no, I'm serious. We dated for like 30 minutes, and I was exhausted. But, you were saying, I'm sorry.
I was just talking about Deb.
You had your story.
Anyway, go back to what I was saying. She, she just said that he showed a great dog and that he was a genius. You are a genius.
Hmm. See, back then, I was a bit of a big man on campus, and I would take a... Daddy's talking. And I would take a just kind of an innocent, supple Friday evening and just cram three full Saturday nights right up in there. And just we would go to town, and sometimes I wouldn't wake up till a Tuesday morning. Don't knock it till you've tried it. But then I met you.
Right.
And we like our movies.
We like the same things. Mm-hmm. We really do.
It's a bit of a, help me, it's a bit of a...
See, American Love Story.
Oh, it yeah. is. It is.
Oh, man.
Oh, no. Great big, how would you say, love story, maybe a great big letters they up did. On the marquee.
Oh, that's right.
That they just say, us.
It was amazing. But anyway, it was kind of the thing that brought us together. You know, our love for the old MGM musings.
Oh, absolutely.
30s and 40s.
You promised Terry we'd talk about it.
I did. Okay. So we decided to, it's something we really wanted to do. We decided to do a calendar. And we got our friend Terry, who's just...
Terry is a photographer.
A fantastic photographer.
And he did for us, because we know Terry.
Know him very well.
He did for us two years ago. It was for his birthday.
You better remember what it was for.
It was a bit of a...
boudoir shots. I'm sorry.
Not for your eyes, sister. So that's what that was. So we decided to take something that we love, and Terry, he loved us, and he especially loves our dogs. And we would take that and with our love of film, and we would put it all together and just set the world aflame. But it probably won't happen.
I mean, we're not going to sell them or anything. You know. What?
We should totally sell them. Shut up,
really?
Yes.
You shut up,
it
no.
is a great idea.
Yeah. I totally see that happening.
I just think that... I mean, I know what you want to do with the money, but... Talk about that.
I mean... Maybe we can do send the Shih Tzus to some type of Shih Tzu rescue.
Oh, good, because they don't have enough money as it is.
We have plenty of money.
Yes. Remind me of the last time we were walking down street and we saw on the side of the road, full of dust and excrement, this poor Shih Tzu with its paws sticking out going, please, sir, alms for the poor.
A little match girl.
Oh, God. Well. But, so, these are our babies.
Yes, they are.
This is Lady Angelina Madonna III. And she is my little girl. And this is Princess Zeke.
This is my baby. And we love our baby so much.
Yes, we do.
Yes, you do. Ow. Bite me. No, yeah. You don't bite me.
I know what you should do.
Should I?
I think someone should sing.
Okay, I write songs for our babies. And I wrote one last night. And should we do it? Should I do it? They can do it.
Save my
baby. I'm going to do it. Please. Now, forgive me, I had to write it down because it's new. Mm. I'm going to stand up and sing.
Would you?
Yes. My dog, come here. Can you hug the baby? No. This is for him. They buried Barbara in the old church. They buried William right beside her. And from her grave grew a red rose. And out of hers, prior. You pretty little day. You pretty, pretty day. Mm. It's okay.
That was lovely.
It's fantastic. Mm. We would really like to thank all of you guys for coming out to our showcase.
Every one of you for coming out today.
I want to shake every single one of you hands. Here, hold my baby.
Please do.
Hi. I'm Antonio. Hi. 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 Hello. Well, you know. Hi.
Every time will be like that.
Hi.
You okay?
Yeah.
It wasn't that long for you. Well, I'm getting a bit.
We need to go. Thank
please
you
do.
So much.
Can you get those for me, please?
I will take care of it. Stay away from the rosé. Mm.
Thanks, guys.
See that these people, they're enormously talented, as you can see. They work really hard at their craft. And again, I really believe that once you do something that's really organic to you personally, like like Keegan and Javon. No, like
organic.
That's organic.
Organic. Orgasmic. Or Mary. Now, you know, Mary, look, if we were just going to read lines from a script, we wouldn't be actors. We'd be script readers. Actors bring their lives to their parts, their own lives. And that's what makes everybody unique, because we're all unique people. Now, it's just up to me as a teacher to make sure that that's happening. Mm-hmm. But it's also up to their commitments. You know, it's about commitment, it's about discipline, it's about determination. And you could bring all of that into your lives. In anything you do, if you care about it enough.
Yeah, maybe not so much.
If you don't, then find something that you care about. Like Keegan and Antonio's done.
Why are you giving them all? What? Looking on us.
You know what I'm saying? And believe me,
I do like
once you guys commit to whatever you're doing, and especially in a field where you want to make a lot of money, then you could be like what Sammy. Sammy has been with me 11 years. Is that better?
Yes, thank you.
and he never did a part in a movie before he met me. And in the 11 years, he's done over 50 movies. And he's made some good money. And you don't look at the money aspect, that's gonna come if you care enough about something. You know? I mean, look at these people. Excellent work. And they're gonna continue to do it as long as they buy in what I'm trying to help them learn. You could win. Just care enough. I thank you all very
thank
much.
Thank you all very much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, Geronimo Katz.
Did I tell you that story? I went on an audition.
Special agent. Damn good one, too. But it wasn't always that way. Many years ago, back in 2016, my partner and I, we were chasing a kung fu assassin through the streets of Detroit. Cornered him in a back alley. And I was gonna let this punk know that his time was up. So I yelled out, "Your time's up, punk." My partner went to put the cuffs on him. But all of a sudden, the assassin started speaking some Ching Chong devil language. He jumped in the air and he cut my partner right in half. His body became a blood volcano. I saw his hopes and dreams and what he'd had for breakfast spill out on the pavement right before me. I just met him around lunchtime, but already he was like a father to me. I reached down, and I picked up his disembodied head. I knew he wasn't gonna make it. So I reached for my gun. But before I could pull the trigger, I was struck by lightning, and also bitten by a cobra. I blacked out. All of a sudden, I was in a dream. I was flying. I saw thousands of people beneath me, practicing the ancient art of kung fu. And then I heard a voice. It told me that I would fulfill a prophecy. And it taught me one of the most powerful forms of kung fu ever devised. And I awoke. I was faster, stronger, more smarter than I had ever been before. And the assassin looked me in the eyes, and he called me the chosen one. That's why we have to go back in time to kill Hitler.
Yes, yes, yes. That was a surprise for Keegan. I never saw him do that. So, who are you carrying all those bricks for anyway? God? Is that it? God? Well, let me tell you something. Let me give you a little inside information about God. God likes to watch. He's a prankster. He likes to sit there and laugh his fucking head off. It's the biggest gag reel of them all. Look, but don't touch. Touch, but don't taste. Taste, but don't swallow. It's the biggest goof of all time. And while you're jumping from one foot to the next, he's laughing his fucking head off.
So let me get this straight then.
No, shut up! He's a sadist! He's an absentee landlord! Worship that! Never!
So then you would rather reign in hell than serve in heaven.
Why not? I've been down here with men from the beginning. I nurtured man with all his imperfections. I've been here. I'm a fan of man. I love man. That's right. Who's to deny, Kevin, that the 20th century was not mine? Entirely mine! I'm peeking. This is my time. This is our time.
Do you want a drink? Because I want a drink.
See that these people, they're enormously talented, as you can see. They work really hard at the craft. And again, I really believe that once you do something that's really organic to you personally, like like Keegan and Javon. No, like
organic.
That's organic.
Organic.
Orgasmic. Or Mary. Now, you know, Mary, look, if we were just going to read lines from a script, we wouldn't be actors. We'd be script readers. Right. Actors bring their lives to their parts, their own lives. And that's what makes everybody unique, because we're all unique people. Now, it's just up to me as a teacher to make sure that that's happening. Mm-hmm. But it's also up to their commitments. You know, it's about commitment, it's about discipline, it's about determination. And you could bring all of that into your lives. In anything you do, if you care about it enough. If you don't, then find something that you care about. Like Keegan and Antonio's done.
Why are you picking on us?
You know what I'm saying? And believe me, once you guys commit to whatever you're doing, and especially in a field where you want to make a lot of money, then you could be like what Sammy. Sammy has been with me 11 years. Is that better?
Yes, thank you.
and he never did a part in a movie before he met me. And in the 11 years, he's done over 50 movies. And he's made some good money. And you don't look at the money aspect, that's gonna come if you care enough about something. You know? I mean, look at these people. Excellent work. And they're gonna continue to do it as long as they buy in what I'm trying to help them learn. You could win. Just care enough. I thank you all very
thank
much.
Thank you all very much.
Thank you.
Did I tell you that story? I went on an audition.